A lot of coaching upheaval in the Pac-12. Willie Taggart leaving Oregon, going to Florida State.
Matt Dudick threw some shade on Twitter at Taggart, which was quite interesting. So
we're going to have to go search for it.
Yeah.
Tell us.
If you go to Zona Zealots, you'll see, I asked Coach Dudick what he meant, or, you know, are you saying what we think you're saying? Something about what comes around goes around or something like that. I don't know. But it was funny.
Smith is the new head coach at Oregon State. He was the quarterback there from 1998 to 2001, and he was the Washington offensive coordinator for the past four seasons.
Washington's been fantastic, so that's a great hire, I would think.
You would think so.
Yeah.
In your division, you've got Chip Kelly. What do you think of that at UCLA?
He finally landed, and somebody said he went to UCLA because Phil Knight would have been upset if he went to a Nike school, so he picked an Under Armour school. But, you know, everybody thought Chip Kelly was going to come back to college eventually. We all thought he'd go back to Oregon. But UCLA came calling with their new facilities and all the money there and, you know, the glory. I'm getting mixed reactions from the Bruin fans, but it's a good hire, right? Almost every college would have wanted him because of what he did in Oregon. But the idea is that what he did in Oregon, he can't redo because now everybody's doing it, so he has to do something new.
Mm-hmm.
But the press
conference, that's the big question.
Yeah.
Because he was ahead of his time in developing offenses, but everybody's pretty much doing what he did.
Right.
He's been doing it more effectively if you look at the metrics of how many plays are being run per game and all the things that he brought to the table in trying to wear out a defense and keep them guessing and keep them on the run. But we'll see.
Well, yeah. And, you know, Peterson's been around long enough, right, at Washington. They've played him. So there's some new coaches, but Rich Rod's played against Chip Kelly before. You know, I think Mike Leach was around when Chip Kelly was there, right? Let me tell you, I'm very happy Mike Leach is still in the Pac-12. I love Mike Leach. If none of you have heard Mike Leach talk about different subjects, Bigfoot, baloney, he went off on the playoff system. It was classic Mike Leach. He's deadpan, but when he says something, it's like you start agreeing with him. Like, I'm so happy he's still in the Pac-12 because I love listening to him and writing about him and interacting with. He interacts with me on Twitter, and it's quite fun.
What's wrong with the playoff system according to Mike Leach? I know that there's a ton wrong with the playoff system. I've been talking about it for a week straight. But what does Mike Leach think's wrong with the playoff system?
I think he doesn't think there's enough teams is what I seem to remember.
No, there's not.
That he wants more of a playoff. He says at every level they have playoffs. So they have playoffs in the NFL. They have playoffs in D2. They have playoffs in D3 or whatever. So all the divisions have playoffs except for D1 football doesn't. So that was his argument.
I think Mike Leach is a lot of fun too. He's fun to listen to. Like you say, he's just a goofball who chooses these odd topics to talk about and just spews forward. There's very little filter there. It just keeps running. Now, I wouldn't want him coaching my football team.
Well,
that I wouldn't want. Listen to him talk. Maybe I would want him to run my offense, but he's not going to do that. All right, and then you get Herm Edwards, who's coaching your rival now, and that was a hire out of the blue, out of nowhere.
Except for it wasn't, I guess, if you know all the relationships, because the guy who hired him was his agent. So his former agent, Ryan Anderson is his name? Ryan Anderson.
Yes.
Yeah.
So between Herm Edwards in the South and Mike Leach in the North, they're going to keep us entertained, because Herm Edwards, in a much different way than Mike Leach, is going to be preaching.
Preach is the key word. So you said
preaching.
You said preaching, and I watched the entire press conference, and I wrote about it for Zona Zealots. If you guys look it up, hopefully it'll be entertaining. But to me, it was a sermon, and I love the game of football so much that I hate to say this ASU head coach was preaching to me, and I was like all ears. Little bit worried, even though a lot of people think, hey, he's old, he's this or that. You know, he pointed out Dick Vermeil retired for 13 years and came back and coached, and no one said anything about that. And Dick Vermeil is one of his, like, a second dad. And sure, when he was saying that, he broke down almost. And they want to run it like an NFL program, so they're going to change it up. And I guess he's going to rely more on his coaches and divvy up the responsibilities. But what he wants to do is get into the houses and convince the parents that he wants to raise their son and to become a man first. And education is important and all this stuff. And I'm like, I don't know if Herm Edwards, now that he's been in broadcasting all these years, and, you know, if you respect his opinion, he always tries to help the player that has a problem. You know, in the NFL, in college, whatever, he always wants to go help. He'll make a phone call to that person, and he's changed a few of their paths and lives. And if I'm the parents, like, I'm all in. He's very convincing, but I don't know.
Convincing. As soon as I heard the news, I was like, they're nuts. This is crazy. And it has nothing to do with my respect for Herm Edwards. But now that I think it a little bit through, I can see it working. I wouldn't lay money on it. And if somebody held a gun to my head, I'm going to say that most likely it's not going to work at Arizona State, depending on what their expectations are. What are their expectations? To win championships?
Championships. Why not? Why not Tempe, Arizona? That's 120 degrees in the summer. I don't know, because they have an indoor facility now. But, you know, I'm a little chippy when it comes to Arizona State. Well, I don't know. The new model is he's basically delegating responsibility to the coaches that are already there, and that they expect, the president of the school and Ryan Anderson expect to be a championship team, and they feel like everything's there, that Todd Graham got the academics there, the discipline's in there, the kids don't get into too much trouble or any trouble whatsoever. Listening to them, they're like, why not ASU? And you know what? If I'm a booster, I'm feeling good about that whole situation. They're very polished. Being a former agent, the AD is very, very polished. He hired a man of color that helps, I think, in recruiting as well. But the one thing that was a little bit funny that got, like, what, 50,000 views? I don't know if you saw it, but the Devil's Digest guy.
Yes.
And, you know, it's like, oh, I'm Christian, you know, don't talk about the devil. Man, you're in charge of the Sun Devil, so don't ever think that. So I don't know, like, did he not put the two and two together?
I didn't know where he was going, and I was trying to give him the benefit of the doubt, thinking there is no way he can be that oblivious that he's shooting this guy down. He's like, repeat, where are you from again? Devil's Digest. Oh, well, I'm a Christian.
Well,
I'm like, well, you're going to be wearing a lot of clothing that says devils on it and has pitchforks on it. Yeah. I'm not quite understanding your.
Well, your I think he doesn't pay attention to blogs, right? So if he would have done his research, he would know there's devils in the details, which is devils in the isn't that a fan-sided site?
I have no idea.
Also, fan-sided has one. SB Nation has one. You talk to them, right?
Yes. Sparky. House of Sparky.
So, like, I guess he didn't get all that, but I know people in California who are very Christian who said their kids will never go to ASU because of the mascot. So it is a thing that's talked about in churches, about, you know, going to a school with the devil. So when he said that, I was reminded of some of my friends who said, no, my kids are never going to ASU because of the devils.
Well, I have no issue with that.
Put the two together, right?
Well, if somebody wants to take that stand, I certainly have no issue with that. I don't know how I would approach it myself, being a Christian myself, but I was never offended by the Sun Devils and the mascot, anything. That never even crossed my mind.
No, right.
If you're going to go coach that team, you should either have no issue with it, but shouldn't be calling out some guy who's representing a company that's basically named themselves after the team you're coaching. It was just hilarious.
Did he never look at the logo before he accepted the job? Isn't the logo right on the contract? So that was a funny thing that happened. So we don't wish them any luck. But personally, you know, Herm Edwards is somebody I find entertaining and respect his opinion at least.
If you want to take 3 minutes of time and see Herm Edwards' farewell at ESPN, I just checked it out as you were logging on for us to record here, and it was rather moving. There were a lot of tears shed.
Yeah, and he said, you know, I'm a person, I just don't up and leave. So I want to leave the right way. You know, I'm like, everything he said, I loved. He's very, I always say magnetic. I know you know the word that I want to use.
You think he's enigmatic, or do you think he's charismatic?
He's charismatic. He's very
charismatic. Enigmatic means you don't know what you're getting from the person. Oh, they're up and down, hot and cold. They're kind of curious. Yes. Sure.
Or you want to gravitate towards him. So when he was at his bully pulpit on the microphone, he was preaching football. And if you love football, it's hard to not, you know, get into it, you know, just so that.
Well, the one thing that you said concerning what sold you and where he might be successful is he's maintained a connection with high school and college football by coaching at the Under Armour All-Star game for the last several seasons, like five or 8 years, something like that. Yeah, yeah. And so he apparently has a connection with the kids. They love him. They all have told him that he should be coaching. So he can still relate as a 63-year-old guy to that age kid. But at the same time, he's able to go into the homes and the parents respect him and look at him as a father figure who may be strong enough in that area away from football to help their kids and guide them and instruct them.
Well, I mean, the parents he's talking to are going to be in their 40s, right? So he's in his 60s, they're in their 40s. He's a father figure for the parents. So it's almost like grandpa's walking in there going, I'm going to do this for your kid. I'm going to take care of him. I'm going to love him. I'm going to nurture him. I'm going to water him. He's going to grow. You know, plus he's going to eat all your food because he loves the food. So he said he's going to gain about 10 pounds. That's going to be real interesting. The landscape, to me, four coaches leaving or four new coaches is going to change a lot of things. I mean, the Colorado coach is still there. Washington Peterson is still there. The Wazoo, Mike Leach is still there. The Cal guy's only had 1 year under his belt. But in the 1 year, I think he scared a lot of people. And Yogi Roth, right, I think, from Pac-12, had the five top wildest plays in the Pac-12. He produced that this week. Of course, two were from Cal. Two were in the same game, and not one of them was Khalil running 80 yards for a touchdown. But I pointed that out, of course.